You see, Buddha's form, unlike ours, is made up of three aeons of culmination of merits. So what happens is that every part of Buddha's body, every part of his structure, every part of his physique is made up of three aeons of merit. The restriction of negative speech, the various type of negative speech, the restrictions of negative mind, the four types of negative mind, the restrictions of negativities of the body. Imagine a fully enlightened Buddha for three countless aeons. He doesn't have desire or anger or jealousy, but he practices pure metta. So this type of being, when they take rebirth or they take form, their body, every part of their body is a culmination of their three aeons of practice. Therefore, when you hold a statue, a tanka, a picture, an image of the Buddha, when you hold any image of a Buddha, you are holding the symbol and the representation of three aeons of countless merits. Therefore, to see a Buddha, to make offerings to a Buddha, to prostrate to a Buddha, and to create Buddha images puts the imprint in our mind to have the same situation come along for us. Meaning, when we create Buddha statues, we venerate Buddha statues, we sponsor Buddha statues, we make Buddha statues, we prostrate to Buddha statues, we fold our hands to Buddha statues, we offer flowers to Buddha statues. Everything that the Buddha image represents, we plant the seeds in us to achieve in the future.